The possibilities are endless. This is the Eventide H9, and I'm very lucky to have a fully loaded algorithm-wise version on my desk, which you are now looking at. It has about 42 different algorithms that you can buy from the app shop if yours isn't fully loaded. And basically, it is controllable via a software app called H9 Control, which is available for iPhone, iPod, iPad, and the front end of my Mac, which is what you're looking at the moment. The interface reacts and looks basically the same on all devices. Of course, it's going to be slightly smaller on an iPhone, but it is very intuitive and offers a lot. First of all, the clean sound. This is a Redhouse S-Style guitar with Klein S1 pickups in it, and it's running to a Marshall Bluesbreaker and an Albion GS30C, which is a cool amp, and I'll do a demo of it later, but they're running in stereo. You've got the Marshall on your left and the Albion on your right. It sounds like this. All right, now I can turn the pedal on via the active switch here, which is easy enough. And I can use all of the tap controls. I can flick through presets like so, and I can get into the hot switches and inner depth controls, all sorts of stuff just with the pedal. But if I want to have some fun with an iPad or an iPhone via remote, let's say I'm standing on a stage, I've got an iPad in my hand so I don't have to keep bending over and adjusting algorithms. Very, very handy. I'm going to show you that interface while I'm sitting here, and it's running on my Mac. So first of all, down the bottom, we've got a selection of algorithms, and you can see that this is fully charged. So, for instance, if I wanted to use the chorus algorithm from the Mod Factor, there it is, and all of those controls that you would find on the actual device are available to me, including the activate switch. So with the H9 control interface, I can use our little, I call it the little death ray down here, and it will adjust whatever algorithm I set it, whatever parameter I set it to. So I can say, okay, I would like it to start at, over here I hit this little hot button, and I'll set the speed for flat out. And the intensity, so we can actually hear it. And over this side, I would like the speed to slow down and the intensity to not be so hot. So we've got. Okay, a bit of fun. There's also the XY pad, which lets you do that. And I can right click on it, so perform mode. I can pretty much control any of the algorithms with it as well. So there I'm controlling depth. Back to the algorithms. Let's choose something along the lines of the shimmer, which is pretty, you know, full on. The Nero's Ascent program here. look, mum, no hands. I can go to the XY pad and I can choose something along the lines of like the pitch. Now you know that's going to be a lot of fun if you're performing, especially if you're doing ambient work. So it is pretty damn crazy. All right, let's go back to the algorithms. So there you go. They're all laid out in a very logical form if I want vintage delay from the time factor. Let's throw a little bit of distortion in front of it to hear what it sounds like with it. I've got a Wampler Velvet Fuzz at my feet, which is pretty cool. I'll just run. So let's have a look at the presets list. Now, you've got two lots of lists here, one for the Mac and one for the actual pedal itself. I've got no presets stored on the Mac at the moment, but I've got plenty in the actual pedal. In fact, there are 99 sitting there. So if I wanted to dial up something like the hall, which is preset 6, double click it again and it actually brings up the interface for it. I can adjust it accordingly. And then, of course, if I want to, I could just save it. And there it is, saved. Also, we've got, within the pedal, all of these different parameters. For instance, if I want to use the tuner, etc., etc., and then I can go back. I can also choose my bypass mode, DSP relay, which I've got it on at the moment. Relay, of course, is true bypass, so we'll leave it on that. Kill dry audio, global tempo, tons and tons of stuff. Too much to go into here, but it's very thorough. If you want to go into the store, there is a store. You can go and buy yourself some more algorithms. Preset lists, let's say I want to edit that list. I can easily do that if I want to say the hi-fi, which is, I can just simply drop it into there. That's how easy it is for you know, your live performance and stuff. Once again, let's just go back and have a quick look at some of these sounds. I like the rotary sound from each of these sounds that you choose from whichever algorithm, for instance, the mod filter, will have a number of presets on its own, so you can experiment to see what actually it does. You can also choose all of those different algorithms on the left-hand side here, so you've got instant access to them. For instance, the dual verb. Thank you. Look, just tons of fun. Check it out. The H9 is fabulous because it consolidates all of the factor pedals and then some, and you can load up to, at the moment, up to 42 different algorithms into it, which do a ton of different stuff. It's stereo in, it's stereo out, you can remote control it by Bluetooth, you can remote control it from your computer. It's small, it has a tiny footprint, it's solid. Everything that you've just seen me do on the screen, you can actually do from the pedal, of course, with it's quite ingenious layout, and it sounds great because there are Eventide algorithms, which are, you know, the best in the world. I'm going to do some more demos as time goes on, just showing you some of the different sounds. You would have already seen some of my demos, perhaps for the other factor pedals. In the meantime, have a close look at the Eventide H9. It offers a lot more than I can possibly go through in this video. So I'm going to have to do a lot of them. See you soon.